It means what for him? If you don't speak English the way somebody in England speaks it, you are not competent. That's the reasoning of Hans. If you don't speak like that, okay, you are not a native speaker, which is totally wrong. I don't speak the way the Cookies speak. I don't say I need a bottle of water. No, I say I need a bottle of water. Sorry, sometimes. Sorry. Okay. So that's why we should reconsider the notion of communicative competence. Now, sticking to this model in higher consciousness might end up. If we follow the model, Hans model, you know, the result will be all of you who are learning English as a foreign language, we feel that you will never be a good speaker of the English language. Because you can never match with them. You can never match with the excellence. Thank you. That's great.
You said you need a
That's great. So you will be frustrated because you can never speak like someone. Staying here, remaining here in Japan or elsewhere part of the world, you can never speak English the way somebody in London speaks it. And you will be frustrated. So, as I said, provided with model that faithfully restrict the expressive potential of language, language has a great potential. And well, if you stick to one particular model, you may fail. Now, what do we need? What is needed that promotes cultural diversity? A lot of people from different ethnic groups are speaking the English language. Why not? Why not, you know, promote their culture? Why not promote their culture through the English language? Why not make language, English language, a multicultural language? And sees it as normative, it means we produce normal emphasis. So it will lead me to say that emphasis should be made on language that is cross-culturally imbued. You see, when I speak, if I speak English and you speak English, I am allowed, following the idea I am advocating here, I am allowed to draw from my mother tongue. I am allowed to make transfer from L1 to L2, which is the English language. And by drawing from my mother tongue, I will use a lot of, you know, cultural hints of my mother tongue. You too. So English language will become somehow a very rich language in terms of cultures, with S. So that's what we should normally promote. That's what we should go for. Make English, as it is an international language, since I am daily using it. And believe me, I am daily using the English language because I teach every day, with the exception of weekends. And when I don't teach, I read. I read books. So I am in contact with the English language every day. So why not give me the possibility to draw from my mother tongue? Why should I put aside what I have learned from my mother tongue? No, let me draw from it, make some transfers, provide they are right, and then you make some transfer from your mother tongue, and when we speak this English will be, you know, will be English that is close, with you and me, cross-culturally imbued, feel it. So that's the idea, that's the point. I'm not the only person who is claiming this. A lot of people are talking. Haus is promoting this. Say, Barbara Seidenhofer is promoting this. Who else? Thomas is promoting this. Sandra Lee Maki is promoting this. Cem Apetkin from Turkey is promoting this. So a lot of scholars are for this version of English. not to stick to the model of the native speaker. So, why I told you that to consider the English speakers as a model is not good? Look, the problem were they there. Targeting the competence of an idealized native speaker will inevitably lead us to what? Miming his behavior as it is an unrealistic objective. Because I told you, you can never be like a cooking man. You can never speak English like a cooking man. You can never speak English like someone coming from Kingston, for instance, or coming from elsewhere. So what you will do, you will try to copy-paste, you know, copy then paste. But what, by pasting, you will mimic. You will use the same way that parents mimic a human being to speak, you will mimic him. So, then, again, another point. The fact that you set the native speaker as a model will demise the second language learner, what? His own sociocultural values, based, as I said, unsuccessfully, a foreign culture. What you will try to do? You will put aside your culture, your own culture, and then try to adopt the culture of the English language, which is, I mean, strange. And it has nothing to do with you. So this is a point. Another point, it will prevent you from drawing on your mother tongue culture, which becomes redundant. So what you will do, you will put aside all what you know about your own culture and adopt another culture, which has with which you've got no ties at all. So that's why people are rejecting any model based on the native speaker.